how to calculate the amount of nutrient in a complex. Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Now I'm going to answer my own question as a follow-up to Matt's. Okay, so this is how to know what percent of something in a complex form gives you what percent of the nutrient of interest if you ever want to calculate it yourself. So I'm going to share my screen. So what you want to do, let's say you want to know what percent of alpha-GPC is choline. What you want to do is say alpha-GPC molar mass. And Google gives it to you right here, 257.221. And then you want to say choline molar mass, 104.1708. And so you want to take this number, the nutrient of interest, and you want to divide it by this number, the dose of the complex form. And then you would get 0.404985. So that rounds down, if you carry it out to two digits, that rounds down to point. Alpha GPC is 40% choline. And if you want to find the amount of choline in alpha GPC, you take the dose of alpha GPC and you multiply it by 0.4. Or if you want to be highly specific, you multiply it by this number. And you can do the exact same thing for magnesium, glycinate, iron, bisglycinate, et cetera. The only thing that you want to be careful of is that it does help to look at the structure of something to make sure that there's only one unit of that nutrient in that complex. So for example, iron bisglycinate, you know from its name that there is two glycine molecules for every iron, and you will have to take that into account by doubling the contribution of glycine to the weight. But sometimes that's not evident in the name. And so if something is, you know, magnesium glycinate, it helps to Google magnesium glycinate structure, look at it and make sure that there's only one or, you know, if there's two, et cetera. So verify with the structure that the unit is one-to-one, or if it's not, double or triple, whatever there's two or three of. But in general, divide the molar mass of the nutrient of interest by the molar mass of the entire complex. Actually, you don't necessarily have to do that. If you take the molar mass of magnesium glycinate, then you don't care whether there's one or two glycines there because you're not dealing with the molar mass of glycine. So actually dealing with the molar mass of the complex versus the molar mass of the nutrient of interest allows you to get around knowing the structure because the molar mass of the complex should be incorporated into it should incorporate the information about how many of each unit are in that complex. All right, I hope that helps anyone who cared about that, because you know you could ask that question for 1,000 different compounds. So there you go.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.